Waldvogel is the young man that made the tackle for the Bears, and right there, Archibald will have the football first down and 10 on their 20-yard line. I have to check and see. Gabe Peterson, the quarterback, looks like Gabe will start the game here tonight as he looks at his teammates, sends them out, spreads them out, and he'll be the only guy in the backfield as we get started here tonight. Camden Warnke is the only wide receiver here on the home side. He's got triples on the top. Now he will bring a Sam Peterson behind him, and he'll hand the ball to Sam Peterson. Peterson makes the first guy miss at the 20, and he'll dive forward to about the 23-yard line. So give Peterson about three. Royster makes the tackle for the Bears. Actually spotted at the 24, so give him four, make it second down and six. They'll spread everything out again wide. Single receiver on the home side, triples to the top. And Peterson, the only person in the backfield right now, calls the snap, throws the ball. Quick little hitter that is complete by Camden Miller, and he'll be right there at the 30-yard line, and I think he's got just enough for that first down. And they will move the sticks. Nye makes the tackle for the Bears. Miller makes the catch on the little in pattern right there at the hash mark at the 30-yard line. And it's first down and 10, so two plays and a first down already for the Archibald Blue Streaks here this evening. Toby Walker will be in the slot here on the home side along with Gavin Grimm. And they'll pitch. And Sam Peterson will sweep. And he'll get back to the 30-yard line as he comes to the home side and gets knocked down by Miller, Nate Miller. Give him about a yard. Culler also there on the help. Peterson gets about a yard. They're going to say almost a yard and a half.
Nice coverage there by the Golden Bears to not let that get all out of sorts.
So it's second down and a long eight right now for Archibald, and they will utilize a running back this time. As Camden Miller is the running back in the backfield. And we've got a whistle, and before the play starts, a procedure call will go against Archibald. So instead of second down and eight, it's going to be second down at about 13. And these are the things the teams that are 2-4, Chris, do.
Yep.
You know?
Absolutely. As I said earlier when I was talking to you, the team that makes the fewest mistakes is the team that's going to win.
Bears have Clayton Farrell on one end, Royster on the other end. Waldvogel's playing the right tackle spot right now, and Connor Ford the left tackle spot for the Bears.
I tell you what, the referees did not do a good job of spotting that 5 yard. It was like 5 1/4 yard.
Miller again, the only running back in the backfield. Peterson drops and throws to the flat. He's got his guy. Completion out to about the 35-yard line to Shane Bechtel. And Lucas Nye's right there to make the stop. But he gets about half of the yards that he needs. In fact, a little more than that, as it'll set up now a third down at about 5. So give him about 10 yards on that catch. Peterson comes to the sideline and then back out into the huddle. 9:41 to play, just underway here in the first quarter. Archibald got the opening kick. They started on their 20, and right now they're at the 35-yard line of the Blue Streaks, looking for that second first down, and it's third down and about 5. Empty set backfield again. Peterson calls his own number, and he's coming right up the middle of the football field. He'll cross the 35, get to about the 37, and that's all the farther he'll go as Lucas Nye wraps him up around the knees and rolls him backwards. Give him 2, set up a 4th down and 3, and it looks like the Bears are about ready to get the football as Alex Klein comes out to punt away. Now, the Bears had a fake punt against them last week, Chris, and they're going to have to watch, I guess, again for that tonight as Waldvogel drops back to the 25-yard line. Low snap, Klein picks it up, and he's got a nice, tall kick. Waldvogel comes up, and he'll let it bounce. And it will touch a couple of the Archibald Blue Streaks at around the 37-yard line and eventually be down. Nobody really knew where that ball was going. It took a Brian bounce as it hit about the 35-yard line and then came back towards the Archibald goal line. And it'll be down to the 37-yard line. So a nice kick will set the Bears up first down and 10 on their 37. And I'll tell you, this drive right here, Chris, could be a real big confidence builder for the Golden Bears tonight.
Absolutely. It's how you perform out of the gate. First drive here, got to make something happen.
Bears will have Waldvogel in at fullback tonight as Belts is hurt. Rittenhouse will be the I back as they're in that I formation. And they'll turn and hand to Rittenhouse, and Rittenhouse gets forward for a yard, maybe two, off left guard. Out to about the 39-yard line before he is knocked down. So a pickup on first down of 2 yards. It'll set up a second down now and 8 as Rittenhouse gets a couple on first down. 8:23 here in the first quarter as the Bears get started. Good to have you with us here tonight. Zimmerman makes the tackle there for Archbold. Bears now with a receiver to the top and a receiver to the bottom in the I formation. Very much what they've run all year long. And again, they'll turn and hand to Rittenhouse, and John will get a little room right up the middle. He'll be across the 40 to about the 43-yard line, so give him about 4. And it's going to set up a third down now and about 5, maybe a short 5 for the Golden Bears. Josh Jones, one of the wide receivers in the ball game here for the Bears right now. And they'll go in the eye again. Receiver to the top, receiver to the bottom. Fake the handoff to Rittenhouse and throw into the flats, and this one is knocked down. Sam Peterson got a big mitt on the ball that was intended to come out to Waldvogel in the flat. He was close to a first down, but Peterson able to knock that little pass down. And the first third down of the night will go for naught for the Bears, and they're going to have to kick things back. So Peterson with a nice tip. Josh Jones comes in to kick things away. It's fourth down, the long 4. And no kick to Nick Rodriguez, who is waiting on this one back at around the 14-yard line. High snap, but Jones pulls it down. Here comes the rush. Good kick, angling towards the Bryant sideline. It'll take a bounce and go out of bounds at about the 22-yard line. So Archbold will have the ball first and 10. It looks like they'll mark him at the 21, Chris. So again, the offense 3 and out.
36-yard punt. No return.
And it was 7:18 to play here in the opening quarter. The Main Street's scoreboard, the Main Stop scoreboard right now shows 0-0 for both teams. So first and 10 for the Streaks on the 20. Peterson again, all by himself in that backfield. He's got doubles to the top, doubles to the bottom. Turns and he's going to throw it to the top of the football field. He's got Toby Walker. And Walker in that little flanker screen to get about a yard as he takes a step forward, and Lucas Nye, and his number we've called numerous times already tonight, makes the tackle, give him 1 on that catch.
I'll tell you what, he has done a great job all year long, Lucas Nye.
Lucas Nye has done a wonderful job for the Bears all year long, you're right. Tonight the Bears having to substitute some guys in because they really do have some people who are injured. As Damon Belts, the middle linebacker, not able to play tonight, so the Bears going to bring a blitz. Throw to the flank to Peterson. And Peterson hits Peterson in the flat for a pickup of about 4 out to about the 28. Oliphant makes the tackle for the Bears.
There is a flag.
And it's a sideline infraction on Archbold, so it'll just be a warning right now. And the play will net out a pickup up to about the 28, so it'll be third down and about 3, almost 3.5. They'll go with the running back look this time. Sam Peterson will be behind his brother Gabe to his left. Two receivers on the home side. Now they start to motion that way. Peterson takes it. He sweeps the right end. He's not going anywhere. As the Bears will be right there, Alex Potvin, who is filling in for Damon Belts tonight, makes the tackle, and it will be 2 yards short of the first down and set up a fourth down. And just like that, the Bears force the Blue Streaks to go 3 and out at the 5:45 mark. Waldvogel will drop back in single coverage back around his own 35-yard line. Climb to kick, low snap, picks it up on the bounce, gets it away. It's a high kick, but it's not very long. It'll bounce on the 45, take an Archbold bounce this time and roll inside the 40. Then the little backspin brings it right back to the 40, and the Bears will start right there on the 40-yard line, first down and 10.
Again, not bad field position for the Bears. That was a 31-yard punt. And boy, the Bears just need to get something done offensively.
Gonna be an interesting night tonight as Alex Potvin getting an opportunity to play a little bit on both sides of the football tonight, Chris. And for that young guy, a sophomore, getting the ability to play a little bit at the fullback spot now, this time Waldvogel back in as a fullback. Rittenhouse again, the eye back as they go into the eye. First down running play, and Rittenhouse has somebody on his ankles as he touches the football. He's able to lean forward to about the 41 for a yard right up the middle of the football field and set up a second down and nine. Been an interesting night so far. Adam Harold in at the tight end. Jones will be the wide receiver here on the home side coming our way. And on the other side tonight, it will be Bryson Andrews, 28, the other wide receiver on the visitor's side. Again, the I formation for the Bears, and they're looking to throw. Going to try to throw to Jones, who slipped and fell down at midfield. Josh Jones was trying to run it out. He got to the midfield stripe and went to make that cut. His feet came out from underneath of him. That would have been a close one. They were close on that connection, but the ball basically hit the turf with Jones about 5 yards away from it, wishing he'd be able to keep both feet on the ground. That stops the clock with 4:42 to play here in the opening quarter. Again, on the main stop scoreboard, nobody scored so far. It's still 0-0. Again, the I formation for the Bears.
They need to take advantage of opportunities.
Third down and nine. Archbold showing blitz. Bears pick it up, looking to throw that screen pass. They've got it on the top side to Rittenhouse. Rittenhouse will get across the 45, but it'll be tripped up at about the 47, and that'll leave the Bears about 3 yards short and set up a kind of an interesting discussion right now, but the discussion very quickly turns to send the punt team in, and let's kick this football away. Nick Rodriguez again drops back deep. Josh Jones to punt things away in a very quick move in first quarter, Chris. We're down to 4:15 to play in this opening period.
Absolutely, it's been very quick.
Decent snap. Jones gets a real bad kick off the right side of his foot. It'll take a Brian bounce, but it hits at the 35 of Archbold, rolls inside the 30, and will be down at the 28-yard line. So about 25 yards on that kick, and man, I'll tell you, that was just a wounded duck. He got it off the side of his foot. It looked like me hitting a 7-iron the other day at the on the golf course. It was not a pretty day for hitting irons on Monday, Chris. I'll tell you that for sure. Ugly, ugly, and that's what that was.
Not his shortest punt of the year, though.
No, it hasn't. That's the good news.
Or bad news, whichever way.
Yeah, exactly. The Peterson brothers line up in the backfield here. In fact, that's not Peterson. That's Miller now in the backfield. Peterson drops. He's got heat coming. Got the ball off just in the nick of time as he hooks up with Camden Miller, who released out of his backfield's position. And Potvin will make the tackle at the 29-yard line. I'll tell you what, some real good heat by Connor Ford coming that time as Ford hitting just as he got rid of that football. They'll give him three on the connection. And with 3:31 to play in the opening quarter, it'll be second down and seven now for the Archbold Blue Streaks. Again, empty backfield set. Walker is the only wide receiver here on the home side. Here comes the blitz. Ball's tipped up in the air, and I think it's intercepted by the Bears. It is. Culler gets the tip. That ball hit Walker in the hand, went up in the air, and Sam Culler was able to snare it at about the 33-yard line. It'll be first down and 10 Bears. And to your point, Chris, let's see if we can take advantage of this turnover.
Absolutely. Culler was just in the right place at the right time. Ball got tipped around and went right to him.
So the Bears bring the offense back onto the field. The first turnover of the night goes the Golden Bears' direction. Andrews is split up to the top, the only wide receiver now as they bunch in and they'll run to the left side. Rittenhouse has some room. He's off left tackle. He's inside the 30 and he'll be down at about the 26 and a late flag comes in and we'll have to see what this call is. Rittenhouse with a nice pickup, seven, maybe eight, but we'll have to see what the infraction is. Face mask against Archbold, so that'll be tagged on to the run, and it'll set up a first down now for the Golden Bears. And is that the first down for the Bears tonight, Chris?
It is. First and 10 for the
So the ball gets moved to the 22-yard line now of Archbold, and the Bears have an opportunity to maybe make something happen here. Andrews again goes wide all by himself to the top of the football field. Again, the eye look for the Bears. They're a little bit loaded up on the left side, but they'll run to the right side. They'll hand the ball to Rittenhouse, and he gets hit right at the line of scrimmage. He's able to fall forward to about the 20, so give him about two. Zimmerman on the stop there for Archbold. Rittenhouse really had no place to run to, Chris, on that left side.
Yeah, he didn't. It was tied up there.
The left side of that defensive line stiffened up really well on the on that run to give him two. Josh Jones now, the wide receiver, all by himself on the top. Andrews, the wide receiver here on the short side of the field, which is the home side. I formation again for the Golden Bears, and the delay handoff goes to Rittenhouse, and Rittenhouse gets stopped in the backfield. And that is Noah Matten. Matten was able to sneak his way in between the big uglies on that offensive line and get that ankle of John Rittenhouse, and Rittenhouse really had no place to go. He'll lose the yards that he got on first down, and it'll set up a third down of 10 now with a minute and 47 to play here in this opening period. And neither team has scored yet, so it's still 0-0 on the main stop scoreboard with a minute and 38 and counting here in the opening period at Archbold. Double wide receivers go up to the top, a wide out and a slot receiver, and again, the I formation. Novus turns, and he's got a lot of heat coming. He's just going to have to hang on to the football, and he'll be dropped back at the 30-yard line. Sam Peterson, the man that put on all the heat. And again, there's one that Novus just needs to get rid of. He'll lose about 10 yards almost on that play, about seven. Give him eight.
Looks like it's going to be four down territory because Jones can kick field goals, but I don't know if he can kick a 47.
Yeah, and if you were where you were before, you're sitting at closer to something than a low 40, which you might give it a try. Down around that that 8-yard loss makes it about a 39 or 40-yard kick. You might give it a try. Instead, they will not. They'll bring Sam Keller on, and they'll go with three wideouts and two running backs in the backfield. And they'll throw it deep down the center of the football field, and it is knocked down by Josh Jones. That one's almost picked off down around the 5-yard line by Gavin Grimm. And the ball will go over on downs to the Blue Streaks.
Heads up play by Jones.
Yeah,
Grimm, knock it away.
Grimm would have probably pulled that in at about the 5, and he had a couple of blue shirts with him. Where he could have gone, you never can tell, but Jones came over late and knocked the ball away. So it'll be first down and 10 for Archbold at the 31-yard line here, their own. 34 seconds left in this opening period. Peterson again in the backfield. He'll fake to the flanker and keep it himself. He comes right up the middle of the football field, and he's across the 30 to about the 34-yard line. Nye makes the tackle after Peterson gets about four. 22 ticks on the opening clock, and I think we'll probably run this thing to the end of the quarter as the play clock has not started yet. Peterson comes off the sideline with 11 seconds to go. Archbold showing signs of getting a play in. 6 seconds now, 5 seconds. Now Peterson looking to the sideline, and I don't think this is going to go. 2 seconds, 1 second, and that will do it. So quarter number one is in the books. Neither team able to score. We'll send it back to Eric Herman for a break here on the Golden Bear Sports Network.
If it's a home with character and space you dream of, then look no further. Misty King of AmeriMade Realty has a gorgeous home on Ohio Drive that's just waiting for you. With four spacious bedrooms, over 1,900 square feet, a renovated rustic interior, fenced yard, and open front porch, you can't go wrong. Listed for only $158, this is a home you have got to see. Call Misty King today at 419-633-4997 or check out 216 Ohio Drive on AmeriMadeHomes.com. AmeriMade Realty, your hometown real estate pro.
Hey, you in the old silver car. Looks like you could use a new ride.
What?
At Daryl Shirky Ford Lincoln, we can upgrade you to a nice pre-owned vehicle or a new Ford or Lincoln.
How are you doing this?
We have a huge selection of vehicles, and with our aggressive pricing policy, we make them very affordable.
This is pretty aggressive. I don't think a billboard's ever tried to sell me a car before.
Come and see why we are the fastest growing dealership in Northwest Ohio. Hey, you in the white pickup.
Beautiful look at downtown Archbold here.
There you go. Our guys, you know, they give you all the best views from any stadium we're in.
They absolutely do.
Archbold will have the football. It'll be second down and six as we open up quarter number two. Peterson will be back in at quarterback. And he'll have Sam Peterson, his brother, right behind him. Doubles on the visitor's side, and now they'll bring Toby Walker in motion towards the home side. Peterson will keep the football and come right up the middle. In fact, it's brother Peterson, Sam. Sam that pulled that one in. And he will be close to a first down, but just a little bit short as Devontae Royster collapses in from his defensive end spot. It'll be third down now and one. Gabe Peterson, the quarterback, Sam Peterson, the running back. And now they will put everybody out as Rodriguez will be the first man in the slot by Walker. And then the end man is Bechtel, and they'll throw that right across the middle, complete to Nick Rodriguez, who came from that very first slot position right across the center of the football field. And at the 49-yard line, he has a first down, and it'll be first down and 10 on the Archbold 49. Quick little pass right across the middle.
You could see that set up by the Bryan defender that was playing further back. And Archbold just got a good jump on it and able to take it right through the middle.
Sam Peterson now will be in that slot position here on the home side. Toby Walker is the next guy in as they've got triples on this side. Bechtel, the wide out, and they've got a single wide out to the top. Peterson drops. Now he'll take off running right up the center of the field. He'll cross midfield into Bryan territory, and it'll be knocked down by Potman on the Bryan 48-yard line. So give him about three. Second down now and seven for the Blue Streaks. And the Bears really defensively need to come up with a stop right here. They had the opportunity with the turnover in the short field, but the offense couldn't cash it in. Again, single running back in the backfield, that's Miller. Two wing wide receivers and one wide out, and they'll fake the ball. Peterson will roll towards the home sideline. He's being chased, and he's going to throw this one deep, and it's caught. Shane Bechtel, I thought it was going to be overthrown, but Bechtel reaches out down inside the 15 and pulls it in over Sam Culler, and it'll be first down and 10 right at the Bears' 15-yard line.
That was a nice pass, and it was all set up by a block in the backfield by the running back. Once they pulled back from that, the Bryan defender came through really fast, and he was set up by a block from the running back, allowing that to happen.
I thought Peterson was going to throw that one away. He just lobbed it as far and as high towards the sideline as he possibly could.
Was that Rodriguez that caught that?
No, that was Bechtel, 20. Jet sweep goes to Nick Rodriguez. He's trying the left sideline. He's not going to get very far. As Colt Arthur wraps him up right around the line of scrimmage, he'll fall forward for a yard, maybe two. But what looked like a jet sweep that had a half a dozen yards written all over it got ripped apart by Colt Arthur as Rodriguez tried to make the turn at the corner on the visitor sideline. Toby Walker checks back in here for the Archbold Blue Streaks. Second down and eight, and Rodriguez will come to the sideline.
Yeah, he lost his helmet on that last play.
So Gabe Peterson in the backfield all by himself. He'll call his own number straight up the middle of the football field. He'll be down at about the 10-yard line, maybe the 11. Oliphant makes the tackle there for the Bears. Give him about four on that carry and set up a third down now at about six. 9 minutes to play here in the second quarter. Still scoreless here in Archbold, but Archbold now trying to change that here as they have a third down at about five on the Golden Bear 10. They'll send doubles to the top, single to the bottom. They've got a running back in the backfield. I think it's the Peterson brothers in the backfield right now. Gabe and Sam. Gabe will roll and look the other way to try to throw to his brother. And this one will bounce back towards him as a good job by Adam Harold to put the heat on Peterson. Trying the little throwback as Gabe started to roll towards his right, and then he stopped and looked to throw back to his brother who was in the left hash mark about the 22-yard line. About that time, Adam Harold thumped him really good, and the ball bounced a couple of times. They will try a field goal here.
It'll be a 27-yarder.
As Josh Kidder comes in, he will kick from the left hash mark as the Bears call a timeout.
No, Archbold called a timeout because they didn't have all their personnel in. They were looking to run in number 65, Elijah Esquibel. He was not running in, and he started running in, and they called the timeout. So
why don't we call a quick timeout here? We'll just call a 30-second timeout. 8:35 to play here, second quarter on the Golden Bear Sports Network.
Newcomer Schaefer, Spangler, and Breininger is a great group of experts with a common goal, to serve the legal needs of this area with the greatest degree of integrity and excellence. Along with that, they respect and support the athletes in tonight's game for their determination and teamwork. An attorney's relationship with their client is like the one between a coach and their player, a position of trust. Newcomer Schaefer, Spangler, and Breininger are proud supporters of all the athletes and wish them continued success always.
Back here at Archbold, Toby Walker will be the holder. Josh Kidder will try a field goal now from the left hash mark. It's about a 27-yarder. Obviously, Kidder, a soccer player over here at Archbold. So we'll see how good his leg is. Good snap, good placement. Here comes the rush. Kick is off, and it is good. So the first points of the night are scored by the home team, and the main stop scoreboard shows Archbold 3, Brian nothing. 8:31 to play, second quarter here on the Golden Bear Sports Network.
You know, gathering with those we love, we get to catch up and we get to reflect on the past.
It seems like every time we get together, I always learn something new.
Here's the front page of the Columbus Dispatch when we won state baseball tournament, sliding into home plate.
Look at that, the front page. And that's a neat picture.
That was a great memory. I'll never forget that.
At Oberlin Turnbull Funeral Home, we understand that there are special memories that need to be remembered and shared.
Bryan Municipal Utilities has an electric, wavy feeling. We're celebrating.
Things are starting to settle down here at Bryan Ford Lincoln. After the fire, we had to rearrange everything. We brought in new offices for our staff. We reorganized our inventory to accommodate our new layout. Things are starting to feel a little more like home.
Morning, Chip.
Maybe a little too comfortable. Bryan Ford Lincoln, great deals, great people, great experiences.
So Archbold able to score first here tonight on a field goal by Josh Kidder. Sam Culler and Josh Jones will drop back deep for the Bears. Culler will be on the home side back at the 10. Jones at the visitor side at about the 11. And Archbold will shift everybody around just a little bit to make the Bears think, who knows what's coming here? And you never can tell on a Friday night here on the Golden Bear Sports Network. This one's kicked straight over Josh Jones's head, into the end zone, out of the back of the end zone, and it will be a touchback, and the Bears will have the football first down and 10. Well, they had that short field last time, Chris, and that's been really one of the problems with this offense this year. They've not been able to take advantage of turnovers when they had the opportunity to be able to punch something in and make it happen. That offense has just sputtered a little bit.
Yep, absolutely. I got a couple scores for you if you want.
Cool, what you got?
It is Defiance down to Wapakoneta 14-0. Hicksville over Tenora 7-0. Hilltop over Ottawa Hills 6-0. Patrick Henry over Swanton 7-0. Wayne Trace over Holgate 7-0. Van Wert over Bath 13-3. And Montpelier over Gibsonburg 14-0.
So the Bears will come out again in that eye look. And now they will shift everything around. And they'll go heavy on the top side of the field right now. And they will run to that right side as Rittenhouse gets through an opening. And he'll be up forward to about the 25-yard line. So Rittenhouse picks up about 5 yards as he runs behind that offset line as they move the big guys up to the top of the football field and ran behind him. Everybody got a nice block. Rittenhouse got about 5. Second down and 5 here with 8:09 to play here in the opening half.
That's the biggest rush for Rittenhouse tonight. He's got 7 carries, 18 yards.
Waldvogel in at fullback for the Bears. Rittenhouse again in that I-back formation. Nobis goes under center. Now he rolls towards the home sideline. Fakes the pass, calls his own number. Up the sideline to the 29, steps out of bounds, I think right there at the 29-yard line. And I think he's going to be about a yard shy of that first down as he just didn't quite get to the 30.
Wow.
At that point in time, you got to put the head down, lower the shoulder pad, and run somebody over and get to that 30-yard stripe. Instead, it's third down at about 2 feet, foot and a half. Bears again come out with the single wide receiver to the top and the bottom. And the I formation with Nobis under center. Here comes the run blitz straight up the middle of the football field. They hand to Rittenhouse, and Rittenhouse gets knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a yard, and that's why you've got to put that shoulder down if you're the quarterback and get that extra couple of feet. Instead of setting up a third down and one and now a fourth down and one, you'd already had that first down if Zach Nobis would have just really lowered the boom there on the one Archibald blue streak and tried instead of stepping out of bounds. Nick Rodriguez will drop back to his own 35-yard line. Josh Jones will punt from the 15. 7-11 to play. A little bit of a high snap. Jones gets this one away. A much better kick. Rodriguez backpedals to the 30, to the 28. Makes one miss. Now gets a block. He'll cross the 35 and be knocked down at about the 36, I believe, is where they're going to mark him, his forward progress. And that's exactly where they put the football. So Rodriguez with about a 5-yard return. And it's a first down now for the Archibald Blue Streaks. The last time they had the football, they scored the only points of the game as they kicked a 27-yard field goal for the 3-0 lead. Sam Peterson now the running back. He's to the right of his brother Gabe as they're in a pistol look and behind him. Two wide receivers on the home side, and now they put number 4, Toby Walker, in motion towards the visitor's side and pitch in the football. Tries to get around that visitor's end, and he'll get a yard, not much more than that, as the Bears come up and knock him down. Colt Arthur again with the containment on the top side. First guy to make the hit. They'll give him about 2. Oliphant also out there along with Farrell. Second down at 8 now. The clock moving at about 6.5 to play here in this opening half. Homecoming tonight, and the Bears obviously would like to have a way to ruin this for the big crowd that's on hand, because they have a very nice crowd here for homecoming on just a beautiful night here, a beautiful Friday evening. Ken Peterson in the backfield. He'll drop and look to throw this time. He's got time. Now he's running out of it. He throws it deep and out over everybody's head and out of bounds. It was intended for Toby Walker, who was pretty well covered by the Bears out around the midfield stripe. And that ball then went out of bounds over everybody's head in Bears territory down around the 40-yard line, well ahead of anybody for either one of the football teams. So it'll set up a third down now and 8. Clock will stop with 6:14 to play here in the second quarter. Archibald subs Camden Miller into the ball game. I think the Indians are winning tonight big, and that's a good news too, Chris. Good to see the Tribe winning tonight. Miller comes in, and he will be the only running back in the backfield behind Peterson. Double wide receivers to the bottom side. They'll roll that way. Peterson looking to throw. Now he's going to call his own number. He's at the 40, makes a guy miss, and he will get the first down as he crosses the 45 and finally gets knocked down at about the 48-yard line. Culler missed on the tackle. Luckily for the Golden Bears, Connor Ford came all the way over and made the tackle, but not before Peterson picks up enough for the first down. And the ball now on the Archibald 49-yard line, first down and 10 with 6:05 to play here in this opening half.
12-yard pickup.
Looked like he should have been knocked down at about the 45, but a very nifty little move by Peterson to get those extra 5 yards in that first down. Again in the backfield is Miller to his right. They fake the ball to him, throw the little flanker screen to Toby Walker. Walker will get into Golden Bears territory at about the 49-yard line. Lucas Nye is the first guy to get to the scene, and then Nate Miller helps him. They'll give Walker about 3, set the ball at the Bears 48, and the clock will move under 5.5 to play here in the opening half. If you just joined us, the main stop scoreboard has Archibald on top 3-0 with a field goal in their last possession. Only scoring of the night. Again, a single running back. That's Miller in the backfield, and the Bears jump off sides. That's Waldvogel. They took a walk on the wild side as he kind of saw something he liked, and he stepped over the line of scrimmage right in the middle. So that'll cost him five and set up a second down now and about two as the ball marked down at the 43-yard line. Clock is moving, and boy, now this just opens up all kinds of play options, Chris,
absolutely,
for these guys. They can run, they can throw, they can do whatever they want to do.
Second and short's the favorite down.
Sam Peterson will be to the left and right behind his brother Gabe in the backfield. They'll send Walker in motion, and Gabe will keep the football, and they'll try to run for some yardage towards the Archbold sideline, and Culler will come up along with Devontae Royster and cause him to lose about 2 yards back to the 45-yard line. Miller also there. So that'll set up now a third down and about four, almost five, as they've got good four because they've got the ball just inside the 45-yard line, and they have to go just inside the 41-yard line. So about 4 yards here for Archbold with third down and 4:20 to play in the half. They'll send doubles, tops, and bottoms. They'll put Gabe Peterson all by himself in an empty backfield. And before anything gets started, Archbold wants to talk it over. We'll take a timeout, too. 4:14 to play first half. Main Stop Scoreboards has the Bears down 3-0 here on the Golden Bear Sports Network.
They say there is strength in numbers. In Bryan, we have always taken pride in supporting our Golden Bear student-athletes in all of their sporting endeavors. The Bryan Athletic Boosters now have a chance for you to get into the game. If you're Bryan proud, it's time to become Bryan strong. Whether you were a BHS athlete, are raising a BHS athlete, or just love supporting our Bryan High School athlete, this is your chance to be part of the BHS sporting community. Talk to any board member today on how easy it is to join, or contact us at 419-636-4536.
Back out at Archbold, 3-0. Streaks with 4:14 remaining first half.
And the Streaks called the timeout. That's their second here in the first half, so they have one remaining for the Golden Bears. They have all three of their timeouts left if they get this football back and need them. Archbold will send triples to the top. A single receiver here right in front of us. That'll be Bechtel and Peterson all by himself in the backfield. Miller will be in the slot, and then you move forward. Peterson in the next spot as Peterson looks to throw towards that left flat, and he's got his man. It'll be close to a first down. If it's not enough, it'll be Grimm who pulls this in, and it will be enough for a first down as Grimm will be forward just inside the 41 to about the 40 and a half. He'll have it by a foot, maybe a foot and a half. First down and 10 as Archbold converts on a third down at about five. And with 4:09 to play, the clock now working in Archbold's favor here as we're heading towards the half. Bears defense needs to stiffen right now, not allow the Archbold to put any more points. Well, at least not a touchdown, I would say, Chris. If they're going to give something up, another field goal won't kill him. Peterson in the backfield to throw that little flanker screen to Sam Peterson. He makes the first guy miss on the home sideline, and he'll get knocked down by Sam Culler, but not until he's deeper into Golden Bears territory, down to about the 31-yard line. So give it nine on that little screen pass to from brother Peterson to brother Peterson. And it's second down and one as the clock moves under 3:20 to play here as Archbold breaks the huddle.
Walker, second short.
Walker, the only receiver to the top. They have triples right in front of us here on the home side and an empty backfield here for Gabe Peterson, who's in the pistol, and he's coming right up the middle. He's got the first down. Now he's got a block. He's at the 20-yard line and finally down at the 19. So well-blocked run right up the middle of the football field. Sam Culler makes the stop at the 20, and if Sam didn't make the tackle, Gabe Peterson was on his way to the goal line.
12-yard pickup on that one.
Liberty's up on top of Wauseon 7-6, I think. Is that what I heard?
Yep.
Is that the score that you had too, Chris?
Yep.
Clock now down under 3 minutes to play in this ball game as the Peterson brothers line up in the backfield. Gabe in the pistol, Sam right behind him to his right. They send Rodriguez in motion, and before anything happens, we have a procedure call against the Blue Streaks. And instead of being first down and 10, from the 20. It'll be first and 15 from the 25.
Couple of updates. Let's see what was different. Delta over Evergreen, 14-0. Ayersville over Fairview, 14-6. Liberty Center over Wauseon, 7-6. The Patrick Henry Swanton game still 7-0 in favor of the Patriots. And Tenora and Hicksville now tied at 7.
There you go. Walker, Rodriguez, and Bechtel go to the top of the football field. Single receiver here on the home side. The pump fake, and now they're going deep into the end zone. A high, long, deep pass will be out of the end zone. Intended for Toby Walker. He had some pretty good coverage back there by Colt Arthur, who had him stride for stride. And Peterson, who's a pretty heady quarterback, saw that good coverage and decided that he was going to throw it to that back pylon. And if anybody was going to get it, it was going to be a guy in a blue jersey. And instead, it went harmlessly out of bounds and all of the way to the track. So 2:14 to play. Clock stops now. Sam Peterson in the backfield to the right and behind his brother Gabe calls for the football. They send a runner in motion, and now Gabe will sweep right sideline. He'll get knocked down after he picks up a couple of yards inside the 25 to about the 24. Devontae Royster, the first guy to make the tackle there for the Bears. And that's a pickup of about 2, and sets a 13-yard third down here now for the Blue Streaks. Clock under a minute and 50 and moving here, and then it's halftime. And the Bears would like to at least hold the Blue Streaks to nothing more than a field goal try here.
Don't forget, coming up at halftime, we've got the Brian Golden Bear Marching Band.
Trips go to the top, empty backfield. Single receiver here in front of us on the home sideline. Peterson drops, and he looks to the top of the football field, and he throws that ball. He's got his man all by himself as Toby Walker. He found himself right in the middle of that zone, and when the ball hit him in the hands at the 5, there was nobody with a white shirt anywhere close to him. Nice job by Peterson to kind of look everybody off to the right initially and then go right up to the top. And the guy he was looking for had a big number 4 on his jersey, and he hit him right in stride, right up on the visitor's sideline, down around the 5-yard line.
Well, early on, the Brian player had great coverage on the left-hand side. I didn't catch the number of who that was. But right about the 10-yard line, he made a break for it and just went right behind the guy, and the pass was in the air already, and I just knew that was a completion right there.
We've got a blue streak down. Now he's up and hobbling to the sideline, which is good. That's Gavin Grimm. Grimm looks like he's okay, but he was injured on that play, and it looks like it's a leg injury of some sort as he kind of hobbles off to the sideline, much like I would if you were picking me up off the turf after one of those plays.
We got a Golden Bear tying his shoes over there.
So we have a minute and 25 to play in the opening half, and the Bears now find themselves down 9-0 here on the Golden Bear Sports Network. Good to have you with us if you're out there at Q96.5 here tonight, or bryansports.com, or if you're up using any of the telephone apps this evening, or if it happens to be Saturday night, great to have you here on BMU Channel 3. The extra point is up, and it is good. And just like that, the Bears find themselves down 10-0 with a minute and 25 left to go here in the first half, and we'll keep it just right here. Well, Christopher, I'll tell you, that was about the worst scenario that you could ask for if you were Coach Redhead. To force them into a long field goal would not have been a bad situation, even if they would have made it.
Nope.
But to allow that little out and up pass to be wide open at the 5 was about the worst thing that you're ever going to see.
Yeah.
And I'm sure the coaches are over there with their laptops showing everybody exactly what we did wrong. But the key is going to be at some point in time, we've got to figure out how to correct those mistakes and not allow that score right here before the half. So the Bears will have an opportunity. They have all 3 of their timeouts. They'll send Culler and Jones back deep at the 5-yard line. Let's see maybe if they can't get some offense going before the half is over. And the Bears coming up close to the line of scrimmage, just watching for any razzle-dazzle here in the before the half, Chris, because an onside kick would really set up Archbold with an opportunity to put this game away early.
Yep. Brian gets the ball at the half.
Would be nice to be able to move this offense down and put some points on the board, whatever it might be, before this half is over. Here comes the kick. It'll be a good one. Jones will field it at the five. Comes up the right sideline to the hash mark. Looking for a hole, but he gets knocked down before he can get into it. And the Bears will have the football at the 22-yard line, first down and 10. If Josh could have gotten through that gap, he had some wide open spaces right up the right hash mark. But instead, he entered into that hole. Somebody grabbed him by the bottom of the legs there and dropped him right there at the 22-yard line. So it'll be first down and 10, Golden Bears. Novus will come out again. He'll be at the quarterback spot. Looks like Farrell in at fullback right now. And Rittenhouse at the running back at the halfback spot. Double wide receivers here on the home side, and they will make that throw. And the ball is right on the money. But Bryson Andrews could not hang on to it.
I don't know. They're going to say that that's a... it's incomplete.
It is a forward pass, I believe. The Blue Streaks jumped on it right away and said it was a lateral, but the ball just forward as Bryson Andrews was lined up in the slot here at the line of scrimmage, took one step backwards. Nobus took it two or three steps backwards, so it was close, but not able to catch the football. Sets up a second down now and 10, and the clock stops with a minute and 12 to play. They'll load up the right side. They'll run out of the eye. Rittenhouse lost the football. I think he got it back, but there were blue streaks all over him, and he'll lose a couple of yards on that carry. Sam Peterson, one of the guys that made the tackle. Rittenhouse didn't really have the football that well as he headed towards that right guard spot. Juggled it just a little bit, got hit, was able to corral it back in before he got down to the ground. Clock now moving under 40 seconds to play as the Bears come up to the line of scrimmage. Game clock has 12 seconds on it. About 24 seconds differential between the two clocks. I formation again. Nobus goes under center. He'll turn. He'll hand to Rittenhouse, and Rittenhouse will get everything that he lost back off left guard and then maybe a yard. And Archbold will use their final timeout with 26 ticks left here in this opening half, and they will force the Bears to at least kick that football back to them as it will be a third down now, or fourth down and 9, as the ball will be spotted at the 23-yard line. Again, Archbold takes the timeout. A big thank you tonight again to our sponsors, the Main Stops of Northwest Ohio, Bryan Ford Lincoln, Krill Funeral Home and Crematory, the Bryan Athletic Boosters, Northwest State Community College, Andries O'Neill and Lowe, a Merrimaid Really, Oberlin Turnbull Funeral Home, Daryl Shirky Ford, and newcomer Schaefer, Spangler, and Breininger. Well, it's 10 to nothing right now. Bears on the short end of that scoreboard as we check it for the Main Stops of Northwest Ohio. Chris, what are the scores that are jumping on you off your scoreboard right now?
Well, Tenora now up 13-7 over Hicksville. That was tied at 7. Let's see if anything else has changed. Liberty Center now up on Wauseon 14-6. Ayersville over Fairview 14-6. Maumee and Napoleon are tied at nothing. Edgerton over Antwerp 30-6. Wayne Trace over Holgate 7-0, and now Patrick Henry up on Swanton 14-7.
Wow. Jones with a good snap. He'll kick from his 10. Rodriguez is back, and he'll watch this line drive knuckleball go skipping right past him, and it will be down inside the Archbold 30 at about the 28-yard line with 15 seconds left. And Jones that time got a real nice kick.
50-yard kick, by the way.
As he line-drived it, it was spinning, it was wobbling, it was doing everything in the world to look unattractive to Mr. Rodriguez. And he decided, rather than to field that ball at around the 35-yard line, to allow it go by him and be down inside the 30 at about the 27, 28-yard line. I would bet that Archbold, being up 10 to nothing, they're coming out in that victory formation right now. They will take a knee to end this half. And I would think the Bears would allow that to go and not use any of their timeouts. Both teams now head to the locker room. One half is in the books. And on the Main Stop scoreboard, the Bears trail the Blue Streaks 10 to nothing here on the Golden Bears Sports Network.
You know, gathering with those we love, we get to catch up and we get to reflect on the past.
It seems like every time we get together, I always learn something new.
Here's the front page of the Columbus Dispatch when he won state baseball tournament, sliding into home plate.
Look at that, the front page. And that's a neat picture.
That was a great memory. I'll never forget that.
At Oberlin Turnbull Funeral Home, we understand that there are special memories that need to be remembered and shared.
Things are starting to settle down here at Bryan Ford Lincoln. After the fire, we had to rearrange everything. We brought in new offices for our staff. We reorganized our inventory to accommodate our new layout. Things are starting to feel a little more like home.
Morning, Jeff.
Maybe a little too comfortable. Bryan Ford Lincoln, great deals, great people, great experiences.
It tells the story of a guy who is upset because his girlfriend spends more time with her friends than with him. It was Santana's first hit and our first song for you. This is Evil Ways.
opportunities, they're closer than you think. Northwest State has more than 70 degree and certificate programs, so you can start on the path to a rewarding career. Or transfer your credits toward a bachelor's degree. Your future is knocking. What are you waiting for? Opportunities await at Northwest State Community College. Find out more at northweststate.edu.
Andries O'Neill and Lowe is committed to providing you the best value for your insurance dollar. We are an agency built on integrity, offering personal service and sound advice you can trust. That's why we partner with experienced carriers like the Central Mutual Insurance Company for your auto, home, or business insurance needs. Central's quality insurance products are reasonably priced and backed by prompt, professional service, providing value for your peace of mind. Andries O'Neill and Lowe is your local Central agent. Call us today at 419-636-5050.
Back out at Archbold, 10-0 here on the Golden Bear Sports Network. And let's take a look at some halftime stats. Archbold with 7 first downs compared to Bryan's 1. 5 passing first downs for Archbold, 2 rushing for Archbold. Bryan 0 of 5 from third down. Archbold 4 of 7 from third down. Bryan 0 of 1 on fourth down. Bryan just with 20 yards, total yards of offense to 152 for Archbold. 6 yards passing for Archbold to 106 yards passing. 6 yards for Bryan, 106 yards for Archbold. Bryan was 1 of 5 for 6 yards. Archbold 12 of 16 for 106. Bryan had 12 carries on 14 yards on 12 carries. Archbold 46 yards on 14 carries. Bryan was penalized 1 time for 5 yards. Archbold 3 times for 15 yards. 1 turnover for the Blue Streaks, but it didn't hurt him as Bryan was unable to capitalize. And the punts, Bryan has punted 4 times for 151 yards. Archbold just 2 times for 57 yards. Passing, Zach Nobis is 1 of 5 for 6 yards. Rushing, he's got 2 attempts for minus 4 yards. John Rittenhouse, 10 attempts, 18 yards with a long of 6. Josh Jones, John Rittenhouse also caught the only pass for 6 yards. Passing, Gabe Peterson is 12 of 16 for 106 yards. His long was 33. He also had a touchdown. Rushing, Toby Walker, 1 attempt for 1 yard. Gabe Peterson himself kept it for 9 times, 37 yards. And Sam Peterson, 3 times, 11 yards. Receiving, Walker caught 3 balls for 27 yards, including the touchdown. Tony Grimm, 1 reception for 4 yards. Nick Rodriguez, 2 for 12. Shane Bechtel, 2 for 41 yards. Sam Peterson, 1 for 6. And Camden Miller, 2 for 7. Taking a look at the drive summary, Bryan kicked off to start the first quarter. Archbold went 5 plays, 17 yards, and punted. Bryan, meanwhile, got the ball back, went 3 and out, only getting 6 yards, right back to Archbold. On Archbold's next attempt, they went 3 and out, punted it back to Bryan. Bryan then went 3 and out again and punted back to Archbold. Archbold's next play, they went on their second play of from scrimmage. They threw an interception. Bryan got the ball at the 33-yard line of Archbold, unable to do anything with it. They went 4 plays for 3 yards, and they turned it over on downs. Archbold got the ball back. They put together a 9-play, 60-yard drive that took 4 minutes and 2 seconds, culminating in a field goal from Josh Kidder. That field goal was 27 yards. Then Bryan got the ball back, got a punt after a 3-and-out. Then Archbold got the ball back. 11 plays, 64-yard drive, took 4 minutes and 53 seconds, and it was a touchdown as Gabe Peterson hooked up for Toby Walker for a touchdown pass. It was actually a 23-yard touchdown pass, and the Golden Bears unable to stop it there, and Archbold went up 10-0. Bryan got the ball back, went 3 and out, got 0 yards on 3 plays, punted it back to Archbold, and Archbold just took a knee on their 1 play to end the first half. Again, the scoring plays, Josh Kidder's 27-yard field goal, 8 minutes and 31 seconds remaining in the second quarter, and then with 1 minute and 30 remaining in the second quarter, Gabe Peterson to Toby Walker for 23-yard touchdown. Jim, bring you back in on this one. And
man, I'll tell you what.
Those stats were not pretty.
No, 1 first down tonight. You know, you had the opportunity.
And it was by penalty.
Yeah, that's the sad part, yep. You know. You've got a situation where you had the football with the turnover. deep into Archbold territory. You couldn't take advantage of it. But that's been something that's been happening all year long for the Bears at this point in time. They're going to have to become opportunistic. They're going to have to take advantage of some of those turnovers. They had the opportunity last week with Wasion. They couldn't make that happen tonight so far. It's early. Still have a whole second half. But you find yourselves down 10 to nothing because you allowed a very solid offense to get up down that football field right before half and put the touchdown on the scoreboard. Yep. So, Coach Redhead, I'm sure not real happy with these guys. They're over-talking, trying to work a few things out. They're going to have to find a way, though, Chris, to get some offense going and make a few things happen to be able to get back in this football game if they're going to want to have an opportunity to go home tonight with a W.
Absolutely, and they're just going to need to get their offense found. Their offense has been MIA the past couple of weeks, and they just need to get that figured out pretty quickly. Want to take a look at some scores from around the region? It is Maumee over Napoleon, 14-0. Montpelier over Gibsonburg, 14-0. So they are beating the Golden Bears, just not the Bryan Golden Bears. Montpelier has a chance to, I was talking to Andy Briggle a little bit earlier, and Montpelier has a chance they win a couple more games here to make the playoffs and maybe win the league.
Yeah, that would be, tell you what, that would, what a great move it was for Montpelier to be able to make that move to get out of the NWOAL. And had some really solid athletes this year, an opportunity maybe to take it into not only the league championship, but who knows, maybe a first round of the state playoffs.
Yep. Wapak over Defiance, 28-0 at the half. It is Hilltop losing to Ottawa Hills, 7-0. Tenora over Hicksville. They are up 13-7 in the second quarter. It's Bath now over Van Wert, 18-13. Liberty Center up at Wasion, 14-6 in the second half. Patrick Henry and Swanton now all tied up at 14, second quarter. It's Ayersville over Fairview, 14-6. Delta over Evergreen, 35-0. No score reported for Toledo Christian and Eden. It is Edgerton, though, over Antwerp, 30-6. And Wayne Trace, the Raiders, up 7-0 over the Tigers and Holgate. We'll take a quick break. We'll come back. We'll do some more talking about the game here at Archbold. Back after this on the Golden Bear Sports Network.
At Creel Funeral Service, we are professionals with the sincere desire to reward every family who have placed their trust and confidence in us by being attentive to every detail, displaying the highest level of courtesy and compassion, and providing the greatest measure of respect for their wishes. As remembrance planners, our goal is to help families find joy in the way they choose to remember, honor, and celebrate the wonderful life of their loved one. Creel Funeral Service. We are experts at helping hearts heal.
Andries O'Neill and Lowe is committed to providing you the best value for your insurance dollar. We are an agency built on integrity, offering personal service and sound advice you can trust. That's why we partner with experienced carriers like the Central Mutual Insurance Company for your auto, home, or business insurance needs. Central's quality insurance products are reasonably priced and backed by prompt, professional service, providing value for your peace of mind. Andries O'Neill and Lowe is your local Central agent. Call us today at 419-636-5050.
Looking for a home in the Eden School District? Then you've got to check out AmeriMade Realty's listing at 507 Madison Street in Blakeslee. This three-bedroom home has been completely renovated and is much bigger than it appears. With over 1,800 square feet, it has a large family room with stone fireplace, large open kitchen, and formal dining. It also offers a double lot, a massive garage, and a deck for entertaining. Phone Misty King of AmeriMade Realty at 419-633-4997 or go to AmeriMadeHomes.com. AmeriMade Realty, your hometown real estate pro.
Hey, you in the old silver car. Looks like you could use a new ride.
What?
At Darrell Shirky Ford Lincoln, we can upgrade you to a nice pre-owned vehicle or a new Ford or Lincoln.
How are you doing this?
We have a huge selection of vehicles, and with our aggressive pricing policy, we make them very affordable.
This is pretty aggressive. I don't think a billboard's ever tried to sell me a car before.
Come and see why we are the fastest growing dealership in Northwest Ohio. Hey, you in the white pickup.
Newcomer Schaefer, Spangler, and Breininger is a great group of experts with a common goal, to serve the legal needs of this area with the greatest degree of integrity and excellence. Along with that, they respect and support the athletes in tonight's game for their determination and teamwork. An attorney's relationship with their client is like the one between a coach and their player, a position of trust. Newcomer Schaefer, Spangler, and Breininger are proud supporters of all the athletes and wish them continued success always.
Halftime at Archbold. We're going to see the Archbold marching band combined with the Bryan Golden Bear marching band. to perform together, God Bless the USA. You're watching on BMU TV Channel 3 and listening on BryanSports.com and WQCT Bryan. Neat to see, Jim, the two bands coming together at halftime.
Yeah, no, that was, you know, that is really good, and two really good bands,
yeah,
too. Brian and Archibald, both with great music programs, and they put a nice piece together there. You know, it's good to see those guys get together on the middle of the football field and entertain the crowd here tonight. So I'm entertained. I'm also well fed. They do a good job of that here.
Absolutely. I love the grilled stuff. Best food in the league, man. Tell you what. I do have one score update I didn't have on my one source, but I've got it on my other source. 30-0 Eden over Toledo Christian.
Oh, wow. There you go. How are the big games? I've been kind of trying to pay attention to you. How's PH doing right now?
Let me update here and see what we got.
And I last I heard, they were up over Swanton, and LC was up over Wauseon, too, huh?
Yep, they're tied right now. Let's see what we got here. I'm getting it. Love the technology. All right, let's see. Mommy over Napoleon, 14-0. Wapak over Defiance, 28-0. Tenora over Hicksville, 13-7. Bath over Van Wert, 18-13. Liberty Center up on Wauseon at the half, 14-6, Jim.
Okay.
Montpelier over Gibsonburg, 14-0 at the half. Wayne Trace over Holgate, 14-6 at the half. Hilltop over Ottawa Hills, 12-7. Patrick Henry and Swanton tied up in the second quarter at 14. Ayersville over Fairview, 14-6. Delta over Evergreen, 35-0. And Edgerton leading Antwerp, 30-6. I'm going to check that another source for my Patrick Henry score just to make sure that it is indeed the way I expect it to be. Let's see, they're at the game, so they should have, Channel 11 is at the game tonight, so they should have a good score there. Let's see, Patrick Henry. They still report it second quarter, so they must not be at halftime.
Okay, there you go. So it's an interesting football games all the way around the area tonight. We're about 3 minutes away from the kickoff of the second half here. Why don't we step away and take a quick timeout? When we come back, we'll get ready to do some football here in the third quarter. Bears trailed the Blue Streaks tonight 10-0 here at the half on the Main Street scoreboard, on the Main Stop scoreboard. I trying to get that out. I had me
a Well, they have a thing on Main Street. No, they don't. They have a thing on High Street. I was trying to cover for you
and
there.
Nah, you're okay. I had to, just an old guy thing doing that, and plus trying to dig a little bratwurst out of the
I haven't heard of Blue Flashes yet tonight, though. So.
Well, we'll get that in for Zach here a little bit. He's been, texting the Blue Flash. The party must be a little bit slow down there at the Columbus Bureau tonight. 2:06 to play. We'll step away right here on the Golden Bears Sports Network.
You know, gathering with those we love, we get to catch up and we get to reflect on the past.
It seems like every time we get together, I always learn something new.
Here's the front page of the Columbus Dispatch when we won state baseball tournament, sliding into home plate.
Look at that, the front page. And that's a neat picture.
That was a great memory. I'll never forget that.
At Oberlin Turnbull Funeral Home, we understand that there are special memories that need to be remembered and shared.
Things are starting to settle down here at Bryan Ford Lincoln. After the fire, we had to rearrange everything. We brought in new offices for our staff. We reorganized our inventory to accommodate our new layout. Things are starting to feel a little more like home.
Morning, Jeff.
Maybe a little too comfortable. Bryan Ford Lincoln, great deals, great people, great experiences.
They say there is strength in numbers. In Bryan, we have always taken pride in supporting our Golden Bears student athletes in all of their sporting endeavors. The Bryan Athletic Boosters now have a chance for you to get into the game. If you're Bryan proud, it's time to become Bryan strong. Whether you were a BHS athlete, are raising a BHS athlete, or just love supporting our Bryan High School athlete, this is your chance to be part of the BHS sporting community. Talk to any board member today on how easy it is to join, or contact us at 419-636-4536.
Looking for career opportunities? They're closer than you think. Northwest State has more than 70 degree and certificate programs, so you can start on the path to a rewarding career or take your existing skills to a whole new level. Your future is knocking. What are you waiting for? Opportunities await at Northwest State Community College. Find out more at northweststate.edu.
And we're back here at Archbowl as the Bears get ready to receive the opening kick. Don't forget tonight, basically in the conference, you've got Wasion, Swanton, and Patrick Henry all at 3-0, Liberty at 2-1. So that's why it's so important with the games that we're following for you here tonight. Bryan at 1-2, Archbowl, Delta, and Evergreen at 0-3. So Delta here right now and Archbowl both trying to turn their fortunes around just a little bit as the Bears will send Sam Culler and also Josh Jones back deep here as we get things going in the third quarter. Had to take a big stretch and get a little oxygen in the brain, that one living brain cell, Christopher, as we get ready to go. And the Streaks will have Josh Kidder kicking things off. The Bears really just need to get things going here. A fresh new 12-minute clock. This ball kicked to Jones. He'll field it on the Bryan sideline at the 20. 25 up the sideline and out of bounds at about the 34, maybe the 35-yard line. Maybe that'll spark this football team a little bit as Jones was able to catch that one on the run and advance it to, let's see, they're going to say he stepped out of bounds
at 33.
Right around, where are they going to stop him? 33-yard line. So Bears football, first down and 10, 33-yard line. Zach Nobis in at quarterback. And he's got to get this offense clicking here in the third quarter.
Absolutely.
Lucas Nye will check in at basically a tight end spot. I formation for the Bears. Single wide receiver to the top and the bottom. Pitch and a sweep around the left end. And Rittenhouse will get trapped in the backfield, and he'll lose a yard, maybe two, on a first down sweep that's going nowhere, and a late flag. And that'll come against the Bears, maybe for a trip or a kick.
Personal foul is the call of the penalty against the Golden Bears.
And that's exactly the way that you don't want to start the third quarter. You'll lose about a yard and a half on first down. And after the play is over, you get called for a personal foul that will move the football back 15 yards. inside your 20 all the way back to your 16-yard line. And it will be second down because the play was over. And second down and a whole bunch. And I'm not sure who they called that on, but a kicking penalty against the Bears after the play was over makes it second down and 27. Jones goes to the home side here. Single wide receiver to the top. Again, the I formation as Nobis goes under center. He fakes and will roll towards the visitor sideline. He'll call his own number, and he will dive across the 25-yard line. As the Bears will pick up about nine, and it'll set up a third down now, and still a whole bunch. And again, the personal foul after the play was over on first down really puts the Bears with their back to the wall with 11 minutes to play here in the third quarter. Again, an I formation for the Bears. Nobis will drop. He looks to throw. He's got some heat coming. Now he'll try to run, and he's going to be knocked down at the 21-yard line as he doesn't get away from Austin Wilson, who blitzes from the top side and tracks Zach Nobis down. It sets up a fourth down and 22 now after that loss.
Fourth and long for the Bears.
Nick Rodriguez will drop back at the 40-yard line. And again, Zach Nobis is either going to have to figure out how to put that thing in gear a little quicker or get rid of the football, as you really can't take the sack on third down and a whole bunch. Jones with a good, solid, high kick. Rodriguez will track it, and it'll bounce over his head and take a Golden Bear bounce and be down on the 21-yard line of the Archbold Blue Streaks.
That's a 57-yard kick with that way that that works, Jim. And I tell you what, that was a nice job over kicking, your receiver so that he wasn't able to field it. It goes all the way down to the 22-yard line.
So that's where the Blue Streaks will have the football with 10:09 to play in the third quarter. It'll be their first opportunity of the third quarter after the Bears had a little problem with a personal foul call. They'll spread everything out. They'll go with one running back in the backfield. That'll be Camden Miller. He'll be back into the top. Peterson will pitch it to Miller. He'll try to sweep the right sideline. Lucas Nye wraps him up right at the line of scrimmage and then rides him down for a short gain of about two. And again, Peterson with a high snap as he set that sweep in motion towards the Bryan sideline. And Lucas Nye, who's really had, Chris, as you pointed out in the first half, probably one of his better nights, and he's had a darn good senior season here all the way around. Olafant will be one of the wide receivers. Nye playing, linebackers, as he switches over now to the triple side. And they're going to throw that little flanker screen to Sam Peterson. And Sam Peterson will have enough for the first down as he's run out of bounds by Olafant at the 35-yard line. First down and 10 as they throw that little flanker screen underneath on the home sideline. Clock will stop with 9:22 to play here in the third quarter. Bears have Hartsock at one of the tackle spots. Devontae Royster on the end spot right on top of him, playing a five-man front now for the Bears and two stand-up linebackers. Low snap. Peterson will have to run this one, and he's going to wish he didn't have to as he gets back to the line of scrimmage, and Sam Culler puts a big swat on him. Nate Miller there to help with the tackle. It'll be no gain as the ball spotted right back on that 35-yard line. Clock moving at 9:04 to play here, third quarter. The main stop scoreboard had the Bears down by 10-0. And big Chet Dangler over there working the sideline. He needs to get some mojo going for the visitors tonight as the Bears with a four-man front now looking to try to put some pressure. Jet sweep goes to number four, Toby Walker. And Walker looked like he was going down in the backfield, able to make a couple guys miss and cut it back towards the middle of the football field. And he'll get all the way to the 40-yard line before the Bears knock him down. It'll be third down now and five.
Yeah, they had him chased and pursued and about 4 to 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage. And he able to get out of it, put his head down, and pick up the 5 yards.
Fairland, Jordan Robb, the two guys on the top of your screen, Then it's Hartsock and Devontae Royster on that front four. Bears now with three linebackers. And before everything gets started, Archbold will be guilty of a false start. Oliphant, Potvin, and also Lucas Nye, the three linebackers for the Bears here tonight. And now they'll bring Waldvogel in, and Hartsock will go to the sideline.
Archbold doing what they want to do here. They're killing clock. They're running the football and moving the chains.
Culler and Miller, the safety and corner on the home side, as Peterson looks to throw across the middle, and it's intercepted. Cold Arthur saw it coming. He was playing corner on the visitor sideline, and he steps in front of a pass at the 45-yard line of the Bears. And the second turnover of the night now gives the Bears again good field position, as they'll have the ball first down and 10 on the Bryan 30 or 45-yard line. Clock stops with 7:45 to play third quarter. And the Bears offense needs to take advantage now of turnover number two for the Archbold Blue Streaks tonight.
Absolutely.
Bears again with a single wide receiver to the top and the bottom. And they'll look to throw. Nobis in the grasp, and he has to throw this one away. But a nice job to get rid of the ball and not take that sack, which would have put him about 10 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Yep.
Bryson Andrews was the intended receiver up on the visitor sideline, but instead of being second down and 20, second down and 10, as Nobis able to sense the pressure and throw the ball out of bounds.
Well, the Archbold defender had his legs tied up, but it was a nice job there by Bryson Andrews to come back to the ball and at least try to make a play.
Andrews, the only wide receiver, as they go back to that eye look and they turn and hand to Rittenhouse, and Rittenhouse has to run through a series of Archbold Blue Streaks to try to get back to the line of scrimmage. He'll lose about a yard on that second down carry. And it'll set up a third down and a long 10. They'll call it no gain, but it's really about a loss of a half a yard. It's third down about 10 and a half, as the ball sitting now on the Bryan side of the 45-yard line. 7:10 counting, the clock moving here third quarter. Main stop scoreboard has the Bears down by 10-10-0. Again, that I formation with a single wide receiver here on the home side. Here comes the blitz. Nobis looking, and he's got all kinds of company in the backfield. And this time he won't be able to get rid of the football, and it'll be tumbled down inside the 35-yard line. In fact, they're going to mark him right at the 35-yard line. It'll set up a fourth down and a mile.
20.
And the Bears will have to punt this one away again. So again, two turnovers tonight. Neither time can the Bears negotiate even a first down.
Yep, they had a three and out both times.
As Rodriguez will drop back inside his 25-yard line, and Josh Jones will kick from his 20. Here comes the heat.
Oh,
he got roughed.
That oh my goodness! Did they say he touched the ball? Because he just got drilled.
It sure.
Oh my goodness!
The kick goes all the way up the sideline.
It went straight up the middle.
And was out of bounds at the 21-yard line.
I'll tell you
what.
If I'm Grant Redhead, I'm out there arguing like crazy, man. I have no, there's no way that ball got tipped.
That was about a 45-yard kick, and I'll tell you what.
No way.
Josh Jones just absolutely got slammed at the 20-yard line. The official talking to him right now, but no flag on
that's
the football
terrible.
Field.
What
and
a
he
call.
Got a he got a 45-yard kickoff. So if that
it was
ball
tipped,
got
yeah,
tipped.
If it was tipped, he tipped it. He must have had like a 70-yard kick. Jeez.
That was a
that
tough
was pretty
one to
blatant.
See, not being able to be down on the football
wow.
field. But an empty backfield now for Archbold, as they'll send a receiver in motion.
You'll
and they will
fake
that jet pitch. Peterson will keep the football, and he'll advance it about 2 yards up the football field as the Bears able to stop him after
wow.
a short game. But, yeah, that's going to be one that we'll have to talk to coach about. And you know what? The only thing that leads you to believe maybe they did get it was that he wasn't out in the middle of the football field, but boy, that sure looked like the ball came away clean.
Yeah, absolutely.
And Josh just got hammered. They'll give him about 3 on that first down carry, so it's second down now and 7 as they keep a running back, and that's Sam Peterson in the backfield to the back and to the right. And they'll turn and they'll delay the ball to Sam, and Sam will get tripped up by Potvin in the backfield. And he'll lose about the 2 yards, almost 3 yards that they got on first down. So it will set up a third down at about 9. They marked the ball on the 22-yard line. And the Bears defense, again, needs to just get real nasty right now and not allow Archbold to get any momentum in this drive with a first down here.
Well, the defense has been playing well. The offense just hasn't been able to capitalize.
You're right. 5:07. And by the time they snap, we'll be under 5 minutes here in the third quarter. Again, Peterson and Peterson in the backfield. Gabe calling for the football. Sam to his back. And Gabe comes straight up the middle of the football field. He breaks out of the first tackle. And he'll sneak his way close to the 30-yard line. Sam Culler will make the tackle. But again, the Bears had a good shot at him right at the line of scrimmage. He'll be about a yard, maybe a yard and a half shy with this fourth down. And I would have to believe with a 10-point lead, you really don't take a chance on your own 29-yard line, but stranger things have happened. Here comes Peterson in off the sideline, and he looks like he's going to run a play. And the Bears now may have to call a timeout on the defensive side. Al Peterson with two fullbacks in front of him, looking maybe to get the Bears to jump offside, and then he'll kick this thing away. 4:05, and now Archbold will take a timeout, and we'll take out timeout with him. Had that look like he was going to try to get everybody to jump offsides, and if he couldn't, they would call a timeout, and that's what they did. So with 4:05 to play third quarter, and the main stop scoreboard at 10-0, Archbold will step away from the Golden Bears Sports Network.
Looking for career opportunities? They're closer than you think. Northwest State has more than 70 degree and certificate programs, so you can start on the path to a rewarding career or transfer your credits toward a bachelor's degree. Your future is knocking. What are you waiting for? Opportunities await at Northwest State Community College. Find out more at northweststate.edu.
Back out at Archbold, it is 10-0. And we do have a score update. Patrick Henry now up over Swanton, 23-14.
Oh, wow. PH, man, they're saying we're number one in this conference. And if you don't believe us, we'll come to your place and show you. Alex Klein, the punter, now on the football field, as Peterson had stayed in on that last play. Low snap, he'll scoop it off the ground. Good rush by Farrell, but the punt gets away. It hits on the 45-yard line of Bryan and takes an Archbold bounce. It'll roll inside the 35 and be down to the 32-yard line. So first down and 10 for the Golden Bears with 3:54 to play in the third quarter. And the Bears offense has just absolutely smelled the joint out here tonight, man.
Yeah, they really have. And boy, 10-0, your defense is doing its job.
Yeah.
And one blown coverage is the difference. It'd be 3-0 except for one blown coverage. And, you know, the offense has not been able to do anything tonight. They have, just to give you some info, they have 15 total yards tonight.
Oh, man.
15 yards in the third quarter.
They'll go unbalanced on the front of the line, and they'll run Rittenhouse off of left tackle, and John will get ahead for a yard, maybe two. But so far, Bears trying to pound and pound and pound and hoping for that big old bridge to open up there and allow Rittenhouse to go sneaking through. There are 9 guys pretty much at the line of scrimmage.
Absolutely.
Every time. So if the Bears could open up a hole, Rittenhouse would probably hit the secondary and be on his way to the house. But at this point in time, the running has been so difficult. They pick up 2 on first down. It's second down now and 8. They'll go with doubles up on top. Again, the I formation and Nobis under center. He'll turn and hand off to Rittenhouse. And Rittenhouse has a little bit of a hole right up the middle. He'll be close to the 40-yard line, about the 39 and a half. Give him about 5 on that carry, and it'll set up a third down now. And the Bears will have a short 4 to try to make this first down. Again, they don't have a first down in the second half yet, I don't believe.
No,
right,
they
Chris?
Don't. And their only first down tonight's been by penalty.
So Nobis goes to the sideline, comes back in. Third down, they'll call it about 3 yards here for the Bears. They'll send a receiver to the top and the bottom. And back in that I formation, and Nobis again under center. He'll turn, hand off to Rittenhouse, and Rittenhouse will lean forward a little bit, but he's not going to lean 3 yards forward. He'll get about a foot, maybe 2, and that's going to set up a fourth down. And the Bears, I believe, are going to go for this one. They'll set up about fourth down, and we'll call it
two.
A short three. They say two, but here comes the kicker on the sideline, too. Bears will not chance this one as the ball's right on their own 40-yard line, and they would need to get out to about the 42 and a half. So it's an idea here to give the ball back and then try to keep the field position in your favor. Jones kicks. Rodriguez will field at the 21. He'll spin, but this time he has no place to go as there's Bears right there to make the tackle. Bryson Andrews, who has been a pretty integral part of this game plan tonight. Obviously, when the Bears have to set Damon Belts down, that makes it a little more difficult for them to run. And Damon, especially a good, solid run stuff in the middle linebacker, not into that the game tonight. But Potvin has done a pretty decent job for the Bears so far, along with all of the guys that have been filling in and out as the year goes on. Two halfbacks now as Peterson is in the shotgun, and high snap, and he's going to try to come off right guard, and he's not going to get back. Yeah, I guess he got just back to the line of scrimmage. Might have got a half a yard. Looked like he was going to stop him a little short. Royster jumped on his back, and I thought he was going to drop him there at the line of scrimmage. He gets a yard out of that one instead. Second down and 9. Clock down to a 1:20 now in the third quarter, as the Bears still find themselves on the short end of a 10-0 scoreboard. Again, the two running backs now playing right in front of their quarterback, very much like the Bears will set up oftentimes, and they'll go right back to Peterson again. This time he'll try right side, and this time they do collapse that pocket, and he will not get back to the line of scrimmage. He'll lose about 3. Oliphant will make the tackle for the Bears, and it'll set up now a third down and about 10 and a half. Streaks have not done a bad job tonight converting third downs, Chris.
No, they are 4 of 9.
Miller, the running back in the backfield. He is behind and to the left. Peterson in the backfield. They've got doubles on the top and the bottom. Peterson drops and looks to throw. Here comes the heat. Going to throw this one to the sideline, and Oliphant's going to step in front of it. 20, 15, 10, spins, and he's inside the 9 to about the 8. Peterson was the guy that made the tackle, and after everything's over and done with, there's laundry on the football field again.
Oh, my goodness.
That ball underthrown, and Oliphant was able to track it down, pull it in, down around the 33-yard line. He got a block or two, and it looks like it's going to be another personal foul against the Golden Bears after the play. These are the kind of things that you got to stop. Ball was going to be first down and goal at the 8.
Was it? I think it was at the 12.
And they're bringing this bad boy back out to the 21-yard line. So a 10-yard mark off. Puts the ball on the 21-yard line. And the way the Bears offense has played tonight, it might as well be the other 21-yard line. Let's see if they can change that now. Andrews will go wide to the top. Jones is wide to the bottom. Again, the I formation. Nobis under center again. They'll turn. He'll roll to the left. He'll step out of a tackle and throw the ball into the flat, and he's got his tight end. And that's Matt Harold. Harold will pick up about 4 as he's tackled on the Bryan sideline down around the 16, almost 17-yard line. And that'll be the end of the third quarter. So 3 of them are in the books. The Bears are in the red zone. It'll be second down and 5 when we come back here on the Golden Bears Sports Network. Bears down 10-0.
An insurance policy is essentially a promise to pay for covered losses that occur to your assets. At Andries O'Neill and Lowe, we take this promise seriously, from the minute you accept the policy to the moment the loss occurs and beyond. That's why we place your auto, home, or business insurance with an experienced carrier like the Central Mutual Insurance Company. Our expertise, matched with Central's quality products and service, provide you protection, security, and peace of mind. Andries O'Neill and Lowe is your local Central agent. Call us today at 419-636-5050.
At Creel Funeral Funeral Service, we are professionals with the sincere desire to reward every family who have placed their trust and confidence in us by being attentive to every detail, displaying the highest level of courtesy and compassion, and providing the greatest measure of respect for their wishes. As remembrance planners, our goal is to help families find joy in the way they choose to remember, honor, and celebrate the wonderful life of their loved one. Creel Funeral Service, we are experts at helping hearts heal.
Back here at Archbold, we are 12 minutes away from the conclusion of this one here tonight, barring some sort of a miracle here tonight. But the Bears have the football. They have it on the 16-yard line of the Archbold Blue Streaks. We open up the fourth quarter with the Bears down by 10, and it's second down and 5. Nobis at quarterback. Farrell will be the fullback. Rittenhouse the running back. Andrews the only wide receiver. He's on the Bryan sideline. And the line is overloaded to the Bryan side. Nobis turns. He'll keep the football, and he's going to go right up the center. And that was a nice little play by Mr. Nobis. He'll pick up a couple yards as he'll cross the 15. It'll be third down at about 3. Nobody open as he was looking for a throw. Realized he had a little bit of opening there right up the middle of the football field. Stepped through it, got the couple yards that he needed, and avoided the sack. And it's third down now for the Bears, and they've got a long 3. Ball sitting really pretty much just on the 15-yard line. And they've got to go down to the 11. Handoff, Rittenhouse, and Rittenhouse, I think, will have the first down of the night for the Bears that didn't come via penalty. As he goes off right tackle and gets just what he needs down to the 10-yard line. First down now and goal for the Bears as the ball sits just across the 10-yard line. And we've got a timeout, and this time it's an official timeout.
Pylon got knocked over down on the right side of the end zone.
And with that, they'll reset the clock and rewind, and let's get going. Farrell, the fullback. Rittenhouse, the running back. Andrews, the only wide receiver, and they'll go to John Rittenhouse. He'll dance his way into the hole off left guard for about a yard. Clock running at 10:57. Fourth and final quarter of an NWOAL football game. Archbold here at homecoming would love to be able to get their very first conference win. Bears were hoping for their second conference win tonight. Both teams come in tonight at 2-4. Both teams trying to improve that record, obviously. Jones, the only wide receiver, and he's on the home side with single coverage. They go into that power look. They'll roll to the right and throw to the fullback. That's Farrell. And Farrell will duck his head down and roll into about the 16-yard line. The 6-yard line, I'm sorry. So we get about 3. In fact, they're going to set him at about the 6.5. So third and goal from about the 6.5-yard line. Give him a couple on that catch. Again, the 2 fullback look with Rittenhouse again. And that inverse wishbone look at the halfback spot. They'll fake it to him. Nobis will roll around that left end, trying to beat everybody to the goal line. There he goes, he's in.
Wow.
Nobis able to find a little bit of a second and third gear to get around the corner. He had a big fella trying to track him down, and that was 71, Cash Gehrke, and he could not get to him. And Zach, for the first time really this year, looked like all of a sudden he had that overdrive in his repertoire as he was able to bootleg his way around that left end for the touchdown. Jones in for the extra point, a big extra point right here as they trail right now by 4. Good snap, good placement, and the kick is right through the uprights. And with that, the Bears have finally found themselves on the scoreboard here at Archbold. With 9:42 to play in the football game on the main stop scoreboard tonight, the Bears find themselves down to Archbold 10-7 here in the Golden Bear Sports Network.
If it's a home with character and space you dream of, then look no further. Misty King of AmeriMade Realty has a gorgeous home on Ohio Drive that's just waiting for you. With four spacious bedrooms, over 1,900 square feet, a renovated rustic interior, fenced yard, and open front porch, you can't go wrong. Listed for only $158, this is a home you have got to see. Call Misty King today at 419-633-4997 or check out 216 Ohio Drive on AmeriMadeHomes.com. AmeriMade Realty, your hometown real estate.
Back here at Archbold is number 14 and number 4, the Rodriguez and Walker combo. Walker number 4, Rodriguez number 14. And these two fellas hook up down around the 10-yard line. As the Bears finally put a touchdown on the scoreboard here tonight, Chris, and it took them a while, but they finally also got their first legitimate first down of the night, and I think picked up a second one, didn't they?
Yep, let's see. Yeah, they have three first downs now. There you go, they had one going into that. That, by the way, Jim, was a six-play, 21-yard drive that took 2 minutes and 52 seconds.
Third turnover of the night tonight by Archbold. Three interceptions here so far tonight. That was the first time the Bears were able to convert that turnover into points, which was also another positive sign for the Golden Bear fans out there.
Archbold's had three turnovers on the night. Bears only able to capitalize on one of them. All three have been interceptions by Gabe Peterson.
Yeah, we heard a little bit tonight about maybe them changing quarterbacks this evening. Peterson's had a pretty good night.
He's 13 of 19 for 117 yards and a touchdown.
Nice to have maybe one more pick before the night's over. Jones slips and falls down as he makes the kick, and this ball will take a bounce. And
he touched it in bounds.
It looked like Rodriguez touched the ball down around the 10-yard line. It skipped out of bounds, and the official who was right on the spot reached immediately for his flag and threw that flag. And so it will be a penalty against the Bears for kicking the ball out of bounds. And
that's
it'll bring the play up to the 35-yard line. And now I'm looking to see how the Bryan coaching staff is reacting to that one on that sideline. We are a long ways away from it. We're on the 45-yard line on the other 45, so we are a good 70 yards away from it. So the ball will be spotted at the 35-yard line. It sure looked like Rodriguez got in front of it and may have touched that ball, but obviously the official right on the spot says no. So the Peterson brothers in the backfield, they'll send two wide receivers to the short side of the field, which is the visitor's side, and they'll send one wide receiver to the top, and they'll hand it to Sam Peterson. And Sam would just get a very marginal gain right up the center of the football field, giving the line of scrimmage plus a few inches and set up a second down, and they'll call it nine.
They're giving almost a 36-yard line.
Hartsock and Farrell with the tackle. Ball sitting really between the 35 and the 36. So he got about a half a yard on that carry. Second down. Peterson again in that pistol look with a running back to the back and his right. And they'll sweep towards the Archbold sideline. And Peterson takes a big thump at the 39-yard line. And something went thump above us here, too. I don't know exactly what that was.
I think the Archbold coaching staff is above us.
I think so, too. Somebody wasn't real happy, but a good, solid tackle, I believe, by Mason Olafon on that hit. Just as soon as he made that hit, something went boom ahead of me there, and I kind of blinked my eyes and was waiting for the contact and the impact, and I think it was just somebody jumping up and down. It would be a pickup of about
5.5.
5.5, so it'll set up a third down and about 4 here. Triples go to the visitor's side of the football field. Singer running back in the backfield. Peterson drops and looks to throw across the middle of the field. He's got his guy, and it will be complete. Nate Miller will make the tackle, but not before the receiver gets up to about the 48-yard line, and it'll be a first down.
That was Nick Rodriguez, right?
Yep, Rodriguez with the catch, Miller with the tackle. First down and 10, Archbold, and this is exactly what the Bears need to stop. 8:15 on the clock. And it is moving here in the fourth quarter, and they find themselves down by 3 on the main stop scoreboard, 10-7, after a nice drive the last time they had the football. Doubles to the visitor side, singles to the bottom side. Now they bring a man in motion towards that home side and they hand off. Miller is the man with the run, and he'll be ahead for about 3, maybe 4 yards, but we have a flag in the backfield, and a holding call against Archbold will wipe out about a 4-yard pickup, and we'll get to redo things here at first down and long. Bears will take the call, which happened pretty much at the line of scrimmage, so the ball being marched all the way back inside the 40 to about the 36 and a half. It'll set up a second down now at about 21.
First and 21 for the Blue Streaks from their own 30.
Blue Streaks need to get into Golden Bear territory at about the 42-yard line. They'll send triples to the top, single wide receiver right in front of us, single running back in the backfield. He's off and behind to the right of the quarterback, Peterson, who's in the pistol. Calls his own number straight up the left side. And he'll get ahead for a couple, maybe 4, possibly 5. Royster makes the tackle as he crosses the 40 to about the 42. So give him 5 yards on that first down carry and set up second down at about 16.
Alex Potvin getting in again. We're calling his name a lot tonight.
Potvin playing one of the linebacker spots. And I'll tell you what, you're right. Between Lucas Nye and Alex Potvin, they've been all over the football field tonight. Doubles to the top, doubles to the bottom. Single running back in the backfield for Archbold. Peterson in that pistol look sends Rodriguez in motion. Then he loses the handle, turns around and hands it off to Sam Peterson. And Sam Peterson is met by Golden Bears in the backfield. They'll drop him at the 41 for a loss of about a yard. And again, Potvin in there, Farrell in there. Add Connor Ford's name to that that pile up in the Archbold backfield, and third down now has 17 needed to make it a first down here for the Archbold Blue Streaks with 6:25 to play in the ball game. Shane Bechtel checks into the lineup, and he'll come out right in front of us with Toby Walker. Walker will be in the slot. Bechtel will be the wide receiver. Single wide out on the top. They're going to throw, or nope, they're going to fake the this little pass to the flank, and now Peterson is going to turn and run the other direction, and he gets awfully close to that first down as he's knocked down right at the first down sticks by Nate Miller right in front of the Golden Bears bench, and it's just going to matter as to where they spot this thing. Peterson comes up hobbling
right left, at the stick,
left knee's kind of shaky, and I think they've got him right where he needs to be. If you're an Archbold Blue Streak fan, from looking across the field right now, he looks like he's right on that stick. Now the officials kind of cover things up, but there's the signal, and it's first down as Peterson dropped back. He gave it the pump fake and was trying to go deep. When nobody came open, he took off running up the Bryan sideline. He needed 17. He got 17 and a couple of inches, and it's first down and 10 now. Archbold's football on the Bryan 42-yard line. 6:03 left on the clock here in the fourth quarter. And when you check the main stop scoreboard right now, the Bears find themselves down by 3, 10-7.
That was interesting. A guy came running off late. He was in the huddle. Is that 12 men in the huddle?
Yep, they did break the huddle with 12. Bechtel now the wide receiver all by himself on this side. They'll bring Rodriguez in motion. They'll hand the ball off to Sam Peterson. In fact, that's Israel Reyes. And Reyes on the draw play will get to the 40-yard line. So give him 2. Connor Ford makes the tackle. He's my next-door neighbor, kind of. He lives out in Lakeland Woods with me.
And if you want to play, it'll be second and 8.
Bechtel again, all by himself on our side. Up in the slot on the top is Toby Walker. Sam Peterson right behind the back of Gabe Peterson. They'll throw that ball out in the flank to Walker. Walker will catch it, and he'll advance it to the 35-yard line. Colt Arthur makes the tackle. It'll set up a third down now at about 3. Arthur's had a pick tonight. Be nice to pick one off here right now. Obviously, 2 down territory as the ball's on the Bryan 35-yard line. Doubles top, doubles bottom. Guys in the slot on both sides. Singer running back in the backfield. They'll turn and hand it off to that running back, and Miller will have enough for the first down as he reaches the football down to about the 31-yard line. Oliphant made the tackle, but that moves the sticks again. And all of a sudden, when you really need that defense to stiffen up, Archbold finding a way to get just enough to move the sticks. 4:45 and counting here, fourth quarter. Homecoming crowd, you can probably hear in the background. They're all revved up and fired up and looking for a big night. They'll send doubles to the top, single to the bottom. Got a flanker moving towards the left side. Gabe Peterson calls his own number. He'll roll across the left end and be up the field for about four. And as you said, Chris, a late flag. Peterson will be marked down at about the 28-yard line. But I believe the call is going to go against the Blue Streaks. It'll be holding.
He's thrown right at the 30.
Clock is
take it back to the
stopped 40. At the 4:26 mark now. And as you said, Chris, the ball, nose of the ball sitting right on the 40, and the back of that ball on the other side of the 40 there, as far as the almost to the 41-yard line. So first and 19 for the Blue Streaks. Bears need to stop them now. Triples right here in front of us on the home sideline. Single running back in the backfield. Nobody on the visitor's side. They'll throw that little flanker screen to Walker. He gets a block and another block, and he's at the 30-yard line and knocked down right about the 29. Nate Miller made the tackle, but they got about half of what they needed on that first down throw as they pick up 10, and they'll set up, in fact, 11. They'll set up a second down and about 8. Clock is moving with 3:51 to play in the fourth quarter. Bears need to stop this one and stop it now. They can't afford a touchdown here this late in the ballgame.
No, they can't.
Doubles to the top here for Archbold with a man in the slot and a wide receiver. Single receiver down here, that's Rodriguez. Peterson turns, hands off to Miller, and Miller has an opening, and he's going to have another first down as they tackle him at the 20-and-a-half-yard line. They needed to get to the 21. That'll stretch the sticks one more time with 3:30 to go in the ball game. And all of a sudden, the offensive line for Archbold starting to open up just enough of a hole to sneak a running back through for 6, 7, and 8 yards at a pop.
He's also completing passes, which makes the defense not key in on the run.
Doubles up on the top, Walker's in the slot. Miller's the running back in the backfield. Peterson calls for the ball. He'll follow Miller off the left guard, and Peterson will get stood up, but not before he gets to the 17. So he'll get 4 yards, and that'll bring the clock down to 3 minutes to play in this ball game. And it will run. Bears have all three of their timeouts. Archbold with their 2 timeouts, as they had to burn one earlier in the ball game. Play clock at 21 seconds. Archbold not really worried about that. They're at the line of scrimmage and they're ready to play ball. Toby Walker, the only wide receiver, and he's on the Archbold sideline. He has single coverage. And a running back in the backfield to the back of Peterson and a running back in front of him to the right, and they will run it that way. Hand the ball to Miller, and Miller will be wrapped up. He'll be ahead for maybe a yard, and the Bears will call that first timeout. So Brian calls a timeout, 2:24 to play in the ball game. We'll take a quick timeout with him. Bears down 10-7 on the Golden Bear Sports Network.
Looking for a home in the Eden School District? Then you've got to check out AmeriMade Realty's listing at 507 Madison Street in Blakeslee. This 3-bedroom home has been completely renovated and is much bigger than it appears. With over 1,800 square feet, it has a large family room with stone fireplace, large open kitchen, and formal dining. It also offers a double lot, a massive garage, and a deck for entertaining. Phone Misty King of AmeriMade Realty at 419-633-4997 or go to AmeriMadeHomes.com. AmeriMade Realty, your home. Hometown Real Estate Pro.
Back out at Golden Bear Stadium, Archbold. 10-7, the Streaks on top, and they are driving right now with 3rd and 6 at the 17-yard line with 2:24 remaining. Taking a look at some other scores, let's see if we can get an update on the two we're worried about. Liberty Center up on Wauseon in the fourth quarter, 21-6, and Patrick Henry over Swanton in the third quarter, 23-17.
Wow, a couple of good ball games here as we head towards the end of their games too. So the Bears have a major dilemma in front of him. Third down at about 7 here for Archbold on the 17-yard line. Again, the pistol look as Peterson turns, hands to Miller, and Miller has stood up right at the line of scrimmage. In fact, he might have lost a yard, and that'll set up a fourth down now. The ball will be on the 18-yard line. Hartsog made the great tackle there. The Bears will take their timeout. That's number 2 for them. It'll stop the clock at 2:20 to play in the game, and we'll keep this one right here. So it's fourth down now. Interesting call right now for the Archbold coaching staff.
Field goal. I'd try a field goal again.
Field goal would make it a 6-point game if they could knock it down. The ball right now is at the 19-yard line. It looks like the wind
is going right to left.
Yep, it's sideways, it's crosswise. So you'll be kicking from the right hash mark, probably somewhere around the 28-yard line or so. And the ball will be pushed from that right hash mark towards that left hash mark. And it's moving pretty generously right now. I bet there's a 15-mile-an-hour wind out there. And I don't see a kicker coming on the football field here for the Blue Streaks.
I don't see
Peterson. Maybe so. There he is. You do have a kicker, but it's 14. It's not 1. So now we get to try to figure this out, too, because that's Nick Rodriguez. And if you're the Golden Bears, you got to worry about a little razzle-dazzle here. Rodriguez is going to try this. Now they're going to kick. They're going to step out of that. Toby Walker will go in at quarterback. Rodriguez will come down. And now the Archbold Blue Streaks will take a timeout.
And now they're probably going to line up normally.
Yeah, I don't know what they were doing there. They brought in two guys. And when you don't see a number one out there, you've got to think, hold it a minute, what's going on out there? This is not the kicker. These are two wide receivers in the backfield right now. They made the shift, and then everything was just totally disorganized. They called the timeout.
Wapak over Defiance, 42-0. Van Wert losing to Bath, 25-13. Montpelier up 21-0 over Gibsonburg. Wayne Trace over Holgate, 21-12. Maumee up over Napoleon, 14-7. Hilltop losing to Ottawa Hills, 14-12. And Edgerton over Antwerp, 53-14. Tenora over Hicksville, 20-7. Ayersville over Fairview, 28-12. Eden over Toledo Christian, 44-0.
Now we've got number one on the field. Kidder will kick. This will be from the 26. So it's a 36-yard kick from the right hash mark. Good snap. Ball's got plenty of distance, and it's good. So Kidder connects on a 36-yarder. And Archbold now goes up by 6, 13-7 on the main stop scoreboard. The Bears will have 2 minutes and 15 seconds left and 1 timeout and a touchdown and the point after. And you sneak on out of here with a big W tonight. Yep. And a big smile on your face, Chris.
Yep. When have we had a game? I can't think of the last game I called where we had 2 made field goals by the same team in a game.
No,
that just doesn't happen in high school anymore.
It doesn't,
at least out here.
No. Well, you know, Swanton had that kid that was a pretty good kicker. He made, I think, maybe 1 or 2 a year or so ago that went on. But that had been about it, and I don't remember him making 2. You've got a great point there. But there have been very, very few kickers. If you go back a number of years ago, Wasion had a pretty good kicker.
Yep.
Back when they were very solid, just like they are right now. But they have had a couple of kickers over there. But you bring a kid over from the soccer team.
Yep.
And he figures out the wind, and that was just a beautiful kick that probably would have gone through from another 10 yards, I bet. He'd have hit that one from probably 45.
I look for a short kick right here, Jim.
Jones and Culler are deep. They're close to the goal line right now. And the young man that just made the field goal, Josh Kidder, is waiting for the sign from the official to be able to kick this thing off. Well, do we have one of those old-time Golden Bear finishes in front of us here? This one's going to be driven deep, and Culler is going to watch it hit
out of bounds. Wow, that makes up for the last one. That went out of bounds at about the 2-yard line.
Culler was going back and back and back and running towards that pylon at the goal line, and the ball actually hit on the 2 and jumped right out of bounds right there. So the Bears will have decent field position at the 35-yard line. Now let's see if they've got a 65-yard drive in them, Chris.
Yep. That's what they need.
Josh Jones will be one of the wide receivers. He's heading over to the home of the visitor side of the field. Bryson Andrews will be the wide receiver here on the home side. Again, that eye look. Jones actually in the slot. Nobis turns, and this is a pitch, and Jones is going to try to sweep. And the Archibald Blue Streak saw it coming, and they dropped him for a loss of 10 back to the 25-yard line. Well, it's great to run that sweep, but you had two running backs in front of him, and somebody needs to pick up the blitzing linebacker. And that bad boy is still racing because Josh could have gotten the corner and probably would have had enough for a first down. Instead, he gets dropped for a 10-yard loss, and it's second down now in 19. Nobis drops. He's got heat, and he's going to get drilled back at the 15-yard line.
Goodness.
So this offense is going in reverse, and it all has to do with blocking, guys. That's exactly what happened again as Archibald blows right through the middle of that offensive line and drops Zach Nobis back at the 16-yard line. So it's going to be third down and forever. Ball's going to be on the Bryan 16-yard line.
19-yard loss.
And they've got to go all the way up to the 45-yard line. So third down and 29 for the Bears. And again, a block on an opening play sweep. And you probably have positive yardage on the run. And then no blocks on the drop back by Zach Nobis. And the blitz not picked up. And Archibald looks like they're on their way to a homecoming win tonight in their first league win. Unless the Bears can pull something off that they've really just shown no signs of doing here so far tonight. Minute and 33 to play left in the ball game. The Bears have one timeout. More importantly, in the next two plays, they need to come up with almost 30 yards. Nobis in the pistol look with two protectors, dropping and throwing the ball, and it's tipped and knocked down. Trying to hit Culler up along the Bryan sideline at about the 30-yard line, and that ball was knocked away at the last second. And it'll be fourth down now in 29 as the clock's at a minute 28 seconds to play, and Archibald will use their last timeout to make sure that they have their defense all set up and ready to go. So the Bears played relatively well tonight, but man, again, that offense just cannot get on track. And when they need a block or two, they just don't seem to be able to get it. So it's another week of trying to go back and study the game film and get themselves ready, because next week they'll be heading to Delta in another game that really is a winnable game for these guys. And then they will end up the season with a game against Patrick Henry, and they'll end the year with Liberty Center, and both those two teams are winning tonight. Last time we heard, right, Chris?
Yep.
So let's see what's going to happen. Archibald is going to drop four defensive backs clear back here to the 40-yard line. Bears have to get to the 45-yard line, 5 yards behind their four defensive backs. They drop their three linebackers back at about the 26-yard line, and they will rush three. Bears will go with that power look with the two running backs, one to the right, one to the left of Zach Nobis, and just in front of him. He's in the pistol. Drops back and looks to throw across the middle of the field to Andrews. Andrews was trying to pitch the ball to Culler. It comes out, and it will be whistled dead. So it was completed at the 25-yard line. And they're going to say that that's where the receiver's knee touched down. And that'll do it. Bears had a little trickeration going on there as they threw the slant to the 25, and we're going to try to pitch that ball out. But a good job by Archibald to wrap up the receiver, and the play basically was whistled dead at the 25-yard line, with Archibald now taking over possession, first down and 10 with a 6-point lead. And they'll go into a victory formation as the Bears, without any timeouts. Peterson will take the ball and take a knee. He's going to have to do that a couple more times here tonight, as that clock will work its way down to 1 minute as they set the ball and start the play clock. And start the play clock. 57 ticks. There goes the play clock. 54 seconds. 48 seconds. And I would think that Archibald will allow that play clock, which is at 10 right now, to work its way all the way down, which will leave us at about 30 seconds once they snap that ball on the game clock. They take the snap and take a knee. We are at 30 seconds, and that will do it. They will not start the game clock. And with 23 ticks left to go on the game clock, the play clock will not start, and that will do it for the game tonight. So the Bears will drop to 2-5, and Archibald will go to 3-4. Both teams now with a single win in the NWOAL. But we step away, we'll come back with some final stats here tonight and some final thoughts as the Bears drop a tough one, 13-7 here in Archibald on the Golden Bear Sports Network.
Hey, you in the old silver car. Looks like you could use a new ride.
What?
At Darrell Shirky Ford Lincoln, we can upgrade you to a nice pre-owned vehicle or a new Ford or Lincoln.
How are you doing this?
We have a huge selection of vehicles, and with our aggressive pricing policy, we make them very affordable.
This is pretty aggressive. I don't think a billboard's ever tried to sell me a car before.
Come and see why we are the fastest growing dealership in Northwest Ohio. Hey, you in the white pickup.
Newcomer Schaefer, Spangler, and Breininger is a great group of experts with a common goal: to serve the legal needs of this area with the greatest degree of integrity and excellence. Along with that, they respect and support the athletes in tonight's game for their determination and teamwork. An attorney's relationship with their client is like the one between a coach and their player, a position of trust. Newcomer Schaefer, Spangler, and Breininger are proud supporters of all the athletes and wish them continued success always.
You know, gathering with those we love, we get to catch up and we get to reflect on the past.
It seems like every time we get together, I always learn something new.
Here's the front page of the Columbus Dispatch when we won state baseball tournament, sliding into home plate.
Look at that, the front page. And that's a neat picture.
That was a great memory. I'll never forget that.
At Oberlin Turnbull Funeral Home, we understand that there are special memories that need to be remembered and shared.
Things are starting to settle down here at Brian Ford Lincoln. After the fire, we had to rearrange everything. We brought in new offices for our staff. We reorganized our inventory to accommodate our new layout. Things are starting to feel a little more like home.
Morning, Jeff.
Maybe a little too comfortable. Brian Ford Lincoln, great deals, great people, great experiences.
You're watching Golden Bear football on BryanSports.com, WQCT Bryan and BMU Channel 3, 13-7. The Golden Bears just can't do anything at the end of the game there and end up losing 13-7.
Yeah, you know, it was just a tough night there for the Bears. They fought, but they just can't put any offense together this year, Chris, as we've talked several times. You know, you go back a couple of years ago, it was all offense. We could score the drop of a hat. Nowadays, boy, to be able to put 7 points on the scoreboard, you almost feel like you stole one.
Here's the stat of the game.
Sure.
How many minutes of football are there in a high school game?
48.
Okay.
Yep.
There we have 34 yards total.
There you go. Not even a yard a minute. And only a couple of first downs, too, yep. and the one came by penalty.
Yep.
So it was just a miserable night tonight for stats and offense. Why don't you run down the stats, Chris, and we'll put a wrap on this thing and get out of here.
Archibald had 13 first downs to Bryan's 3. Archibald was 7 of 13 on third down, 2 of 11 for Bryan. Bryan was 0 of 2 on fourth down. Archibald had 240 yards of total offense. Bryan just 34 yards. Archibald 140 through the air. Bryan just 23. 73 yards passing through the air. Archbold had an even 100 rushing on 36 attempts. Brian, 26 attempts for 11 yards. Brian was penalized three times for 30 yards, Archbold six times for 40 yards, and Archbold threw three interceptions. Brian, though, did not have a turnover, which was good. Punting, Brian had seven punts for 288 yards, Archbold three punts for 95 yards. Time of possession, this is not 100% accurate, but close, 18 minutes and 10 seconds for Brian, 28-13 for Archbold. Archbold passing, Gabe Peterson was 16 of 22 for 140 yards. His long was 33, had one touchdown. Rushing, Johnny Reyes, one attempt for 2 yards. Toby Walker, two attempts for 6 yards. Gabe Peterson, 19 attempts for 79 yards. His long was 16. Sam Peterson, seven carries for 11 yards. Camden Miller, four carries for 11 yards. On the receiving end, Toby Walker caught five balls for 44 yards, including a touchdown. Tony Grime, one reception for 4 yards. Nick Rodriguez, three for 18. Shane Bechtel, two for 41. His long was a 33-yard reception. Sam Peterson, two receptions for 17 yards. Camden Miller, two receptions for 7 yards. On Brian's side, Zach Novas, four of 10 for 23 yards. His long pass was 9. Zach Novas also had 8 attempts for minus 8 yards and a touchdown. Josh Jones, one rushing attempt for minus 10 yards. And John Rittenhouse, 17 attempts for 29 yards. His long rush was 6. Matt Harrell caught one ball for 5 yards. Bryson Andrews, one ball for 9 yards. John Rittenhouse, one ball for 6 yards. And Clayton Farrell, one ball for 3 yards. Those are the four balls. Scoring plays, the score opened up with 8:31 remaining in the second quarter as Josh Kidder attempted a 27-yard field goal. That was off of a 9-play, 60-yard drive that took 4 minutes and 2 seconds. That opened the game up at 3-0. Later on in the second quarter, with a minute 30 remaining, Gabe Peterson threw a 23-yard touchdown pass to Toby Walker. Josh Kidder's extra point was good. That made it 10-0. And that play came on an 11-play, 64-yard drive with 4 minutes and 53 seconds. Zach Novas got us on the board as he ran in from 6 yards out with 9:42 remaining in the fourth quarter. That drive was a 6-play, 21-yard drive that took 2 minutes and 52 seconds. And the final scoring play is 2 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter as Josh Kidder attempted a 35-yard field goal and made a 35-yard field goal. His drive that caused that field goal, 15 plays, 47 yards with 7 minutes and 26 seconds worth of clock taken off there. And that was the one that the Bears just were able to stop. The rest of the drives for Archbold, punt, interception, field goal, touchdown, interception, punt, interception, field goal. Brian's punt drives included punt, putt, turnover on downs, punt, 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 touchdown, and turnover on downs.
Oh, man.
Lots of punts in there. So.
Well, you know, most nights when you don't turn the ball over and you pick up 3 turnovers from your opposition, you can normally parlay that into some sort of a victory. But tonight that happened. Bears didn't turn the ball over one time offensively. They did on downs a couple times when they were trying to go for it on fourth down. But no turnovers, no fumbles, no interceptions tonight. They get 3 picks against Archbold. They cannot make anything out of those 3 picks. They were able to put one drive together, as you said. But they fall short tonight on the main stop scoreboard. 13-7. So it's a tough night. You want to check a few scores before we get out of here, Chris?
Yep. It is Bath over Van Wert, 25-13. That's in the fourth quarter. Wayne Trace over Holgate, 21-12 in the fourth quarter. Montpelier over Gibsonburg, 27-6 in the fourth quarter. Liberty Center over Wasion, 28-6. Looks like LC is going to win that one. Hilltop down to Ottawa Hills, 21-12. Edgerton over Antwerp, 53-14. It's Tenora over Hicksville, 20-7. Patrick Henry is up on Swanton, 23-17. Ayersville over Fairview, 35-12. Eden over Toledo Christian, 44-0. Delta over Evergreen, 35-0. Maumee defeats Napoleon, 14-7. Wapak defeats Defiance, 42-0. I want to check one other thing here, one other score, just to make sure that I'm correct on the two scores we're following, just to make sure I have the latest stuff. So hang on 2 seconds, Jim. Let's see. Patrick Henry is up 28-21 over Swanton right now. And Liberty Center's Liberty Center score was last reported in the third quarter, so we don't know about that one.
There you go. Ball game brought to you tonight by the Main Stops of Northwest Ohio, by the Bryan Athletic Boosters, by AmeriMaid Realty, Oberlin Turnbull Funeral Home, Daryl Shirky Ford, Northwest State Community College, Bryan Ford Lincoln, Krill Funeral Home and Crematory, Andrews O'Neill and Lowe, and newcomer Schaefer, Spangler, and Breininger. Christopher, I guess we had Danny was around today, and Big E.
Yeah.
Who else was with us here tonight? Aaron around there tonight with us to help bring the ball game to you. It was a tough loss tonight. We'll head to Delta next week. Still looking to get back on that winning side. 3 weeks left to go in this football season. It's kind of hard to imagine.
Yeah, it's moving really quickly, so.
Bears fall tonight 13-7. That's going to wrap it up here for Marchbold. For Chris Malinga, I'm Jim Funderburg. We'll see you next Friday here on the Golden Bears Sports Network.
It's coming.